approaching here now about 11 crossing with the Island Main Road meets the railroad track. This is the village of Tabernacle. And look in there to our right, where you can see the White House there, under the hill. That's the home of our Prime Minister, Dr. the Honorable Timothy Sylvester Harris. He was also born here in the village of Tabernacle. Our constitutional here on Ireland, elections are due every 5 years. And when the time comes around, we'll go the polls to vote. Now we'll vote for a government of our choice. For our government ministers here, they are not selected, they are elected. And that's his personal home. The only minister that does that in his personal home is the Governor General, who lives in the State House. All of the ministers live in their personal home. Village of Tabernacle. A very long time ago, long before there was ever any sugar cane, we used to grow tobacco here. This was our tobacco growing village. And looking here to our right, a plain area here, where they place their basketball and their netball. As you can see too, they have floodlights there so they can play their games by night. This is the village of Tabernacle. And as we continue to look here to our right, cemetery, the place where people are dying to go. And to our left, on the foothill, that blue and white building, is one of our private schools here. It was named after one of our local educators from right here in this village. That's the Edgar T. Morris Primary School. Side of the road, we can see these trees. They are almond trees. And because of the amount of almond trees we have here going, this area is called Almond Walk. Looking at the trees, you realize they have almond on them. Most of them are green. Now when these almonds are ripe and full and ready, they're brownish in color. We'll eat the outer portion, then we'll pull it out. Inside we have the almond. Soft and delicious. Not as hard as the one that you'll purchase at the supermarket. Now we can eat this almond as a food, or we can use it to make almond sugar cane or almond essence. And these trees that they're here growing, they belong to no one. They're just here growing in the lands that belongs to the government. So anyone can go there, pick those almonds and partake of them. They belong to no one. As we continue to look here to our left, you can see some guava trees. Our guavas are seasonal here. So right now it's not their season, they're here but they're green. Now when the his guavas are ripe and full and ready. They are yellow. We can eat them as a fruit like that. Or we can use it to make a guava drink, guava cheese, or we normally make a delicious, locally made guava jam. And it's something the children look forward to very much around here. Whenever those guavas are ready, they'll go there, pick their guavas, take them home so their parents can make that delicious guava jam, which they would eat at morning with their bread for breakfast. Village here, the village of Bellevue. And Bellevue means beautiful view. A beautiful view of the mountains and also a beautiful view of the seas. So as we continue to look here to our right, across the coastal area here, here is a popular area for our local fishermen here on the island. This area is called Dawson's Bay. Here our fishermen will get up very early in the morning for their catch of the day. They'll catch their mahi-mahi, their yellowtail snapper, their lobster, their conch, a little of everything right here at Dawson's Bay. As we continue to look to our right, between these homes we're seeing here, we can see some wooden huts in an area. That area is called Black Rocks Pasture. It has a name because of the amount of black rocks that is found in the sea. And they got there a very long time ago when the volcano erupted. The lava flowed from the mountain, and when the hot lava connected to the cold water, it formed some black, jagged rocks. There are hundreds of black rocks in the sea. But for you to see it, you have to get up, go there, look over in the sea for you to see. And also you realize that we have some of our locals, they have their craft and their handicraft on display right there at Black Rock Pasture. This is one of our heritage pastures. As we continue to look here to our right, you can see a church with a steeple. That's the St. John's Anglican Church, one of our older churches here on the island. Not the very oldest, but this church is more than 350 years old. Has been here for a very long time, been through all of the weather, the hurricane, the high wind, etc. Look at it. It is still standing. You know, we still use this church for Sunday Mass and midweek services. We have done some repairs to the roof, changing of the doors and the windows, but the structure still remains the same. That's the St. John's Anglican Church, one of our older churches here on the island. And now as we go to these areas, I'll talk about it then. As soon as we go to these areas here now, most of these villages, they were named after the estate. Whatever was the name of the estate would be the name of the village. time to relax once more. The choirs are here again to entertain us. Please sit back as usual, relax and enjoy this singing. Thank you.
Of Sadler.
Sadler was very kind to the slaves when he was about to leave. He decided to sell the land to them at a very cheap rate. In honor of his kind gesture, he named the village after him, Sadler's Village. And 17 primary school. There's a high school right here in this village of Sadler, but the singing was going on at that moment. I couldn't have pointed out to you. We go to the primary school from ages 5 to 12, and the high school from 12 to about 17. You can do your first 2 years of college here on the island. And after that, you can go abroad to finish up your education. You can do your associate's degree here. Now, as we look here still to our left, we can see close in the distance, there was an estate there called Lavington Estate. This is the village of Lavington, named after the estate. Most of these tiny villages we're going to encounter, as I said before, they were named after the estate.
Egrets coming up.
So as we turn our attention still to our right, looking across the coastal area, we can see the outline of some islands. That's St. Martin and St. Bath. St. Martin and St. Bath. Looking across the coastal area there. You can see it right there, very clear today. It's a good day. That's St. Martin and St. Bath. And here, still looking to all right, where you can see the waves here going
St. Martin
in different directions, right here to all right. Here is where the two oceans meet, the Atlantic and the Caribbean. Right here is where the two oceans meet. So we're now going to leave the rough side and we'll be crossing over on the calm side, the Caribbean side, the side where we'll go for sea bathing or picnicking, etc. So here is where both oceans meet.
So here is where both oceans meet. Both oceans meet.
Now, if you look around these areas, you can see some farming being done in that area there. One of the farmers right there. Seeing all of these burnt out patches, you may be wondering what's going on. Well, what happened is that an easier and cheaper way for the farmers to get rid of all the high grass, the high bushes, etc., is for them to burn the area. So what happens when they're ready to use the area, they'll burn it, then the tractor will come in and plow the area, and then it will be ready for them to do their farming. And if you look around all these areas, just imagine they were all sugarcane. Now that we're finished with sugarcane, most of the land have been allocated to the farmers for them to do their farming. Some lands in prime areas have been sold to persons to build their homes and businesses. But the majority of the land was given out to the farmers for them to do their farming. And still looking to our left, we can see an old sugar windmill and chimney. There was an estate there called the Parsons Estate. And to our right, the village of Parsons, named after the estate. Now we're getting close. We have another 45 to 50 more minutes though before we get to the end of the tour. But the other part of the tour, which will be taken by the bus, do not have the use of a washroom. So if you'd like to use the washroom, you may do so now. Or as you go along to use the washrooms, I want you to be very careful. Hold on to the handle steps. Remember, the washrooms are located downstairs on the lower deck. There's a white door. You open that white door. To the left of the white door is a brown door, and that's the washroom. So please, if you wish to go to the washroom, you may do so now. Hold on to the handrails and watch your steps. Here's sweet potato. That sweet potato he has there in his hand. They're harvesting some sweet potato.
More egret.
So right here, the village. Pass. Inside and wait. There's seats inside. If you wish to wait, sit on the inside and wait till it's no problem.
Yeah, they're buff. Yeah, a little buff.
As we go across this area, we can see these wooden poles with the high tension wire on top. Well, this is how we get electricity to all of the different villages. And we use diesel to generate our electricity. We're now in the process of using solar. Our international airport, it is 100% powered by solar. Also here in Ireland, we always have a very good supply of running water. We're never out of running water. We get our water from our wells and our reservoirs. And the water from the tap, it is safe for drinking. And just in case you're wondering, yes, we do have cable television here on the island. So if you wish to tune in to your favorite channel, there's the sport channel or the news channel, or maybe just some entertainment like the soaps or something, you can do so.
Wow.
can hear it all right still. We can see some white roof between those pine trees there. There was a resort called the Golden Lemon Resort. That has been sold to different owners now, so they're doing some renovation. So it's not really being used at the moment. But they have a beautiful beach right there, just in case you're on an island tour and you'd love to take a break. You can drive there, drink a cold beer, look at the waves, relax and look at the waves. That would be a good way to relax. And also, still looking there to our right, we can see that big blue and white building. That's the police station there for the village. As I said, it's the village of Diepe, and Diepe was our very first French town. You can still see a building with an L-shaped roof. The building is painted peach. That's the primary school here for the villagers. It's a primary school from 8 to 5 to 12.